Hi, this is Dr. Mark Sibley from the Florida Eye Center. I'm excited about what you're about to watch. From a patient standpoint, I want to show you something that is simple and safe and successful. And from an eye surgeon standpoint, I want to show you a technique that can help you in case this problem arises. What I'm going to show you is a lens implant that has to be removed, and we're going to exchange it with a new lens implant. I've done about 20,000 surgeries, and this is the first one that is needing this. Even perfect cataract surgery with lens implants may have a result where the prescription is different than what was calculated by the computer measurements for the custom ordered lens implant. So when that happens, the doctor has some choices, and I want to be able to show you these choices and exchanging it for a lens implant of a different magnification, a different prescription, can be accomplished, and it's very simple, and I want to demonstrate that. This is the surgical procedure. There's just a few steps, and the patient's lying down comfortably. The left hand is filling the eye with a small syringe of clear jelly. That was made at the first surgery 1 week ago. The right hand now is just going back into the small opening that we made last week to put in the lens implant that you see. The surgery was essentially perfect and uneventful last week, but the patient, instead of being focused at 20 feet, was focused at 20 inches. So she was nearsighted, and that was not our intent. So her eye anatomy had the lens implant change, and we want to give her the most perfect vision. And we agreed to remove the lens implant that was custom ordered for her. So what I just did was fill that space with the protective jelly. The instrument in my right hand is a special set of scissors. Those scissors now, with the protection of the clear jelly, those scissors have taken the lens implant that we lifted and elevated, and they are going to cut the lens implant lens, which is like a soft contact lens. So I've delicately, under the protection of that medicine, made the cut at least 60% through for the surgeons who are watching. And now the scissors in the right hand are going to go to the top of the lens implant, which is the lens hinge that was the automatic focus part. Now the lens is in three pieces instead of one, and I'm filling the chamber again, and now we're going to take just the simple lens implant forceps, and the lens implant forceps will grasp the hinges at the bottom of the picture, and that's what has led to the automatic refraction. We're just going to remove it now, and the top one-third, and then the middle one-third, and it is out gently and safely. And the last one-third, that top hinge, is all that's left, and we have grasped it and simply remove it. Now, this is just like last week with her uneventful cataract surgery, where we had removed the cataract and put in that advanced technology implant that worked for her, but with a prescription that she wanted changed. I just filled the compartment again with the protective clear jelly. That's just showing the surgeons the tweezers, the forceps that I'm going to use. The new lens implant I'm going to show, I'm holding it. The white hinges, the white hinges can be seen. And We do not need to reopen the eye. It's all done through the small opening on the right. And we have grasped the new lens implant, and there's just that small opening. My nurse is irrigating with some salt water, and I'm just drying it with a Q-tip. My left hand is just going to stabilize the eye. There's no pain. The patient's been sedated and comfortable, and the light is not bothering her. And I'm just going to put the lens implant back in where Mother Nature had it, back in what is the clear capsular bag, which is kind of like a Ziploc. And so the new lens implant in the new prescription is placed in that position. What I'm doing now is just gently rotating it, almost like dialing a rotary, and this is just locating it more in the vertical position, just as one of my techniques, and a lot of the crystal lens doctors do the same technique. So the hinges are there, the lens implant is her prescription. It's perfectly centered and clear. The right hand instrument is just a dual instrument that puts in salt water and vacuums out that clear jelly. This instrument is just literally a small cannula, and I'm just gently irrigating the top and the bottom in front of the implant and behind the implant, just to make sure that there's no other particles and that we keep it as centered and clear in position as possible. I'm just touching the wound that is self-sealing, that second small injection on the right, on the left was to refill it. Now I'm putting a contact lens on that's made out of protein. It's been soaking in antibiotic. We just fill it with the drops, take off the sterile plastic drapes, and remove the eyelid spreader, and we're finished.